Well, we didn't get very far. We literally drove to Morrison's to get some cash out of the cash point. And then we could smell the beautiful food of the Chinese restaurant nearby. And given that we were about to head onto the motorway, the idea that we were going to go and buy something from the service station, which would be expensive, we thought, you know what, let's go for Chinese. So we've got some chow mein's on the way. So we've arrived in London, at a hotel called the Holiday Inn. It's quite late now. We've just had a drink because we've been parched. We had a Chinese earlier, so we've been dry-mouthed most of the way here. We're going to go get some sleep now because we're up at 6 a.m. and then we're heading to the terminal before our departure to New York. So we've arrived at the airport, it's about 7:30 I think now. So we've just parked up. We're gonna try and figure our way out of this car park. So we got to the airport lounge and helped ourselves to a cooked breakfast. So the eggs, sausages, bacon and stuff, so that was really nice. And then Rachel decided to buy us a glass of champagne.
Like to get away, take a holiday from the neighborhood. Hop a flight to Miami Beach or to Hollywood. But I'm taking a Greyhound on the Hudson River line. I'm in a New York state of mind. Stars in their fancy cars and their limousines. Been high in the Rockies, under the evergreens. I know what I'm needing, and I don't want to waste more time. I'm in a New York state of mind. It was so easy living day by day. Out of touch with the rhythm and blues. But now I need a little give and take. The New York Times, the Daily News. Comes down to reality, and it's fine with me, cause I've let it slide. I don't care if it's Chinatown or rotten Riverside. I don't have any reason left them all behind. I'm in a New York state of mind.
So we finally got to our hotel in New York, literally just looking for somewhere to eat right now. Probably gonna start unpacking a few things tonight, maybe have a quick freshen up, and then go and head out for some food. I think we're gonna eat next door at a place called Rare Bar and Grill. We haven't really seen much of the city at all. In fact, as soon as we came out of the underpass thing, a couple of left turns and we were there, so we didn't really see much of it at all. And it's raining, and it's getting dark, and it's cloudy, so I'm not sure if we're going to be exploring anything tonight. We'll just take it as it comes. Well, it's got to be said, I think that steak that I had was probably the biggest I've ever had. there was no fat. It was basically like an extra large sized fillet steak. It was really huge, cooked to perfection. It's not even 7 o'clock yet. So we're gonna just sit up and watch TV, let our food go down a little bit more, and then get an early night, and then tomorrow we can be all refreshed and start our first day in New York. So that was our first night in New York, and because we were quite tired yesterday after all travelling, eating quite a big meal and then getting back, we were just quite sleepy, so we went to sleep. And I woke up in the night feeling like I had a pretty good sleep. I could probably sleep a little more, but I was like, I'm awake, I could go out now. Ooh, what time is it? I looked at my phone and it said it was 1 o'clock, and I was like, oh my god, I need to get back to sleep. 4 o'clock came round, both me and Rach woke up. And 4 o'clock's about 9 o'clock in the UK. So, it's kind of a reasonable time to get up in terms of our body clock. So we got up anyway, just chilled out for a bit. Just got ready, because our plan was to leave about 8 o'clock this morning, or get up at 8 o'clock this morning, I should say, and probably leave for about 9. But it was like, we're nearly ready, I'm ready, and it's 6 o'clock in the morning.
The news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York. These vagabond shoes are longing to stray right through the very heart of it. New York, New York. I want to wake up in a city that doesn't sleep and find I'm king of the hill, top of the heap. These little town blues are melting away.
So here we are on Brooklyn Bridge at 20 to 9. Now, if we got up at what the time we were supposed to have got up, we would be probably leaving the hotel in around 15 minutes' time. But instead, we sorted out our tickets for the subway, got to Brooklyn Bridge, and getting a nice view here of the southern part of Manhattan. We're not going to cross the entire bridge, it's quite a bit of a walk. It's quite cold as well, actually. But we're going to head off now back down that way where we came from. Find Battery Park and just have a little wander around there for a bit.
New York, New York. I want to wake up in a city that never sleeps and find I'm a number one, top of the list, king of the hill. It's up to you, New York, New York, New York.
So we spent a lot of time, extra time, waiting around for Statue of Liberty. And then about 45 minutes before we were due to go, we waited in the ticket queue and they said we needed ID. We could hear them over saying need ID. So I don't have mine. So I had to run all the way back to the hotel to get it. And now on our way. So now we're against the clock to get to Liberty Island. It'll probably take about 20 minutes on the subway, if that. So I think he's got to still make it.
We tried to use the lift in as much as we went by it. And then it says, you can't call the call button, you have to get a ranger to do it. But the ranger was nowhere to be seen. So we're climbing the stairs. We made the first stop at the pedestal, and we can pretty much look up the skirt of Lady Liberty and then head up to the crown area, so that should be quite fun. So we're just about to climb into the crown of Lady Liberty. Wow, the architecture you get in here is unbelievable. And the exterior of the copper shell that makes up Lady Liberty is just... it's amazing work. Now that we're done at Lady Liberty, we're gonna head out and check out 9/11. Site where back in September 11th, 2001, the Twin Towers came down. This building behind me here is the Freedom Tower, the One Trade Center, which has been built since as like a sort of as a replacement, but also as like a memorial kind of thing as well, just to kind of mark the site. And where the tower stood, they've got these waterfall features and all these names. Across here you can see the rows behind me depicting people's birthdays. So it would make you think about stuff when you're here. So we got back from the 9/11 memorial and just chilled out for about half an hour or so. Tomorrow we're going to be eating out, and then the day after we're coming home. And Rachel really wants to try that steak that I had last night. So we went downstairs and we both had the same meal again. It was, oh, honestly, it was a 14 ounce piece of meat. Sorry for how large my head is right now. But we're on the rooftop of our hotel. And as you can see behind me, just in the blue there, is the Empire State Building. Whilst the hotel roof isn't actually that high up, you do get a very good sense of the area, buildings towering over you, and also just a general sense of where stuff is. It's pretty cool. So here are a few shots of what I managed to capture.